वसुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
So we're hearing this Brihad Bhagavat Amrita pastime, the second half of the Brihad Bhagavat Amrita, describing Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Vrindavan, and how he is chanting a mantra, and by the power of the mantra he is able to visit many places.
我们一直在聆听的是大伯加瓦坦甘露布里哈巴瓦塔姆里塔下半部分描述的是文达文的一个牧牛童高哈库马他念诵自己的曼特同时他集这个曼特的力量可以拜访许多地方。So
we heard how Gop Kumar, by chanting the mantra, had gone to the heavenly planets, and when he was in the heavenly planets, Indra had some problem, Indra had a fall down, and he had to go away and hide, and at that time they needed someone to become Indra.
因着由于某些缘故呢堕落了，因着就隐藏了起来，所以，Gopakumar他就代替了因着的地位。So,
Lord, in charge of the heavenly planets is the son of Aditi, in the form of Lord Vamanadev.
掌管天堂的是 Aditi 的儿子。
So Lord Vamanadev suggested that this Gop Kumar should take the post of Indra, and his mother Aditi, she agreed, and their guru also agreed.
Vamanadev 就建议这位 Gopakumar 可以代替天帝Indra的地位。 这样的，阿弟弟同意了，同时，天堂的办事人的guru也同意了。Guru
of the demigods is known by the name Brihaspati.
办事人们的guru名字就叫 Brihaspati.
So in this way, Gop Kumar, just a minute, let me. So Gop Kumar became, he was put on the throne as Indra, the king of heaven. And as the king of heaven, he was very enthusiastic to encourage pure devotional service.
Gopakumar就坐上了Indra的宝座，他非常热情地推广这纯粹的奉献服务。
So, as the king of heaven, he rules the three worlds, Bhuvar, and Swarg, the three different levels in the planetary system, in the universe.
他作为统治者，统治着Bhuvar, Swarga，是整个就是世界的三个星系。
And Gop Kumar was encouraging all the people there to do pure devotional service. Before, the other Indra, he had not encouraged them very much.
Gopakumar他就利用他作为Indra的地位推广纯粹的奉献服务。在他之前的Indra并没有大力地提倡纯粹的奉爱服务。
So So he was the ruling there. He was there for 1 year of the demigods, which is 360 years on the earth planet.
天堂的一年相当于地球的三万三十六万年。
So, while Gopkumar was the king of heaven, suddenly what happened was some great sages appeared there, headed by Bhrigu Muni.
有一天呢, Gopkumar 正在天堂的时候，来了一位以Bhrigu Muni为首的一些圣人们。
And they were going to visit the earth planet to purify the holy places there.
这些圣人们打算去地球净化地球上的圣地。
So Gopkumar was very surprised to see these people. He had never seen them before, and he wondered where they were. He thought maybe there were other demigods who he'd never seen before from the heavenly planet.
库马尔见到这些圣人们，他感到非常的惊讶，因为他从来没有见过他们。他以为这些圣人们是也是来自天堂的其他的半神人们。But
actually, Bhrigu is very senior in the universe. He's one of is born from the mind of Brahma.
实际上 ，Bhrigu 是宇宙当中的非常年长的一位圣人。 是直接从Brahma的心意诞生的。
And Bhrigu is a great devotee. He is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita.
Bhrigu是伟大的奉献者，是在《薄伽梵歌》当中也提到。
Lord Krishna says, Maharshinam Bhrigur Aham. Among the principal sages, I am Bhrigu.
这句梵文的意思是在主要的圣者们当中，我是Bhrigu。
And sometimes Bhrigu Muni becomes the father of Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune.
有的时候，Bhrigu就成为了幸运女神Lakshmi的父亲。
He is an empowered representative of Lord Krishna.
他是主Krishna被授权的代表。
So he's a very important person, and he came there along with other sages to the heavenly planets. So Bhrigu Muni, actually, he comes from the planet above the heavenly planets, which is called Mahaloka.
Bhrigu Muni呢是从天堂之上的星系，名字叫Mahaloka来的。
But sometimes, you know, at the end of the Brahma's day, there's a partial annihilation, a partial destruction, devastation of the planets.
在 Brahma 一天结束的时候，整个星系有部分毁灭。
So at that time, it becomes very hot on Mahaloka, and they go to a higher planet. They go to a planet above Mahaloka called Janaloka.
在这个时候，Mahaloka就变得非常的炙热，那里的居民们便上升到Janaloka。
So why these great sages, they come from their planet, they come from the planet above the heavenly planets, called Mahaloka, they come down to the heavenly planets.
These 来降临到半神们居住的天堂星宿。
And their purpose in coming down was to go to purify the Ganga water and holy places around which flow beside the Ganga.
他们的目的呢是去地球净化恒河以及净化恒河两岸的圣地。
Because the sages knew that many materialistic people come there and leave their sins in these holy places.
这些圣哲们知道有很多的物质主义者去那里，把他们的罪恶留在了圣地。
So these sages were so powerful, they did not really need to go there, but they wanted to go there just to, because they know if the people there on earth would just see them, and then it would be good for them.
这些圣哲们特别有力量，他们本来是无需去地球的。但是呢，他们知道地球上的人们见到他们会感到非常高兴。
So Gopkumar was very surprised because he saw all the demigods were worshipping these great sages. They were worshipping Bhrigu.
Gopkumar 惊讶地看到这些半神们竟然崇拜起 Bhrigu 牧尼为首的圣哲们。
Now usually people worship the demigods, but these demigods were worshipping these great sages.
通常呢，普通人都会崇拜半神人们，但是这些半神们现在竟然崇拜起这些圣哲们。
And even their spiritual master Brihaspati, he was also worshipping these great sages.
甚至连半神人的灵性导师 Brihaspati 也崇拜这些圣哲们。
And even Lord Vishnu himself was even worshipping these great sages.
甚至连主维斯努本人也亲自崇拜起这些圣哲们。
Because Lord Vishnu is Namo Brahmana Devaya, he's very dear to the Brahmanas, so the Brahmanas always serve Vishnu. Vishnu likes to serve the Brahmanas.
因为主维斯努有个名字叫 Namo Brahmana Devaya, 他是特别的喜欢婆罗门。Brahmana, 所以他就崇拜了这些 Brahmana.
So Gopkumar, he was new to the heavenly planets. So he could not know, he didn't know who these sages were. He couldn't recognize them.
Gopkumar 是天堂的新人，所以他并不认识这些圣哲们。
So all the other demigods, they were very enthusiastic to worship these great sages. But Gopkumar, he didn't know who they were. He didn't know what to do.
所有那些半神们都特别的热情地开始崇拜这些圣哲们。可是 Gopkumar, 他并不认识这些圣人，所以他就无所适从。
But some of the other demigods, they told Gopkumar, no, come on, you have to join in too. We're all worshipping them. You should also worship them.
其他有一些半神人就告诉 Gopkumar, 快来加入我们。我们都在崇拜他们，你也跟我们一起崇拜吧。
Gopkumar had been so busy doing his devotional service to Lord Vishnu, he didn't know about these other places in the universe.
Gopkumar 呢一直在忙着服务 Vishnu， 所以呢对于宇宙中的所有这些地方并不太了解和清晰。
But the Lord arranged that he would meet these people and find out about other higher places in the universe.
主就安排 Gopkumar 能够相会这些人们，以便能够了解宇宙间的更高的等的星系。
So the sages, they saw Gopkumar, and they also gave blessings to Gopkumar. And then after that, then they left because they wanted to go to earth to visit the Ganga and purify the Ganga.
圣人们们也就祝福了 Gopkumar， 之后就离开，启程前往地球去净化恒河。
And at that time, then also the Lord Vamanadeva also disappeared.
就在这个时候呢，主瓦曼纳德也一同消失了。
So after that, all these people left, then Gopkumar was able to ask the other demigods about who were these people, where did they come from, what were they doing?
等他们都离开之后呢，狗帕库马尔才有机会问半神们，他们是谁？是从哪里来的？他们要去干什么？
Gop Kumar had to wait until they go before he could ask who they are, because it wouldn't be polite to ask who they are in their presence.
等了这群人走了之后， Gopa Kumar 现在才能够有机会提出这样的问题，因为呢，如果他们在场的时候问这种问题是很不礼貌的。
And Lord Vamanadev, he also had to leave there, because if he would ask about these sages in the presence of Lord Vamanadev, it would not be good.
瓦曼纳戴夫也离开了，因为呢，如果在瓦曼纳戴夫面前提这样的问题呢，也不好。
Lord Vamanadev is the supreme lord.
主瓦曼纳戴夫是至尊主。
So Gop Kumar wanted to know, ordinary people worship the demigods, but these demigods were worshipping these sages. How is it they're so great?
古巴库马尔的问题就是，普通人们都崇拜半神，现在呢，这些半神们反而崇拜起这些圣者们，他们怎么能这么伟大呢
？He wanted to know where did they come from. He said they're so effulgent, you know, they were glowing. So where did they come from?
他们是从哪里来的？他们浑身散发着光灿。他们是怎么能这样的 光彩夺目呢
yeah, Even though Gop Kumar was in the heavenly planets, he could understand these people had, they must come from somewhere above the heavenly planets.
现在的 Gopa Kumar 虽然身处天堂，他也能明白这群人一定是来自比天堂更高等的星系。
But when Gop Kumar asked the demigods about who they were and where they came from,The demigods were all quiet. Nobody would speak. Nobody answered him.
当高帕库马尔提出，这些人是谁？他们从哪里来？等等的问题的时候，半神人们都沉默不语。
Because the demigods, they're proud of their own position, and they were jealous of these great sages being above them.
半神人们，他们对自己的地位感到非常的骄傲自大，他们嫉妒这些圣者。
And they were too embarrassed to tell Gop Kumar who they were.
要告诉 Gopa Kumar 这些人的身份，他们会觉得非常的难堪。
Yeah, because the demigods they're proud of their own position, and they don't like to think other people are above them.
半神人们对自己的地位感到十分的骄傲自满，他们并不想起这个念头，竟然还有人比他们还要高等。
So when Gop Kumar asks his question, they just say nobody speaks, nobody wants to answer.
当 Gopa Kumar 提问之际呢，没有人回答。
But.The spiritual master of the demigods, Brihaspati, he is a bit better than the demigods. So he answers Gop Kumar.
半神人的灵性导师 Brihaspati 比半神人们要好，他就开始作答。
Because Gop Kumar is like the disciple of Brihaspati, so it's the duty of the spiritual master to answer the questions of the disciple.
格帕库马尔就相当于布拉斯帕提的门徒，那灵性导师的职责就是回答门徒的问题。
The disciple has questions, he should go to the spiritual master. Spiritual master will answer.
门徒一旦有问题的话，灵性导师就有义务要回答。
So Brihaspati told Gop Kumar that.Above this world, above the heavenly planets, there's another world called Mahaloka, which is in order to go there, that only the best of pious people can go there, the most pious people.
Brihaspati 就回答说，在我们这个世界之上，还有更高的世界，名字叫 Mahaloka. 要想去那里，只有
And even when the three worlds are destroyed, three worlds means the earthly planets and the planets above the earthly planets, and above that the heavenly planets, meaning Bhur, Bhuvar, and Swarg, when they are destroyed, that planet, Mahaloka, remains.
那在这个地球三界毁灭之际，这三界包括地球、Bhuvar、Svarga毁灭之际，在这时候，Mahaloka依然存在着。So
to go to heavenly planets, you have to be pious. You have to do a lot of pious activities. But to go to Mahaloka, it's even more difficult.
想去天堂，都要从事大量的虔诚活动。 但要去马哈洛克的话，就更困难了。
You have to do yoga meditation, and you have to perform many sacrifices. You have to achieve a very high standard.
需要做瑜伽冥想，需要做祭祀，并且就达到很高的水准。
And you should not have any impure purposes in mind. You should be very pure.
同时，心意当中呢还不能有不洁的意图，心意必须要非常的纯净。So
most of the residents who go to Mahaloka, they're ready. They're getting ready for liberation.
达到Mahaloka的居民们，他们已经做好了得到解脱的准备了。And
that planet lives. The planet remains as long as the planet of Lord Brahma.
Mahaloka 的这个寿命就相当于 Brahma 的寿命.
So the residents of Mahaloka, they're all prajapatis. They're all like progenitors of mankind. They're given the responsibility, you know, prajapati.
Yes, Mahaloka 上的居民们都是 prajapati, 就是人类的始祖。
So they say, you know, the happiness of Indra, the king of heaven, is millions of times greater than any, even a king on the earth planet.
大家要知道的是，天堂的国王Indra的快乐，比起地球凡尘的地球上的国王的快乐要上百万倍。
But the happiness of the residents of Mahaloka, the Prajapatis, is millions of times greater than Indra.
然而，马哈卢卡上面居住的 Prajapati 们的快乐，比起 Indra 的快乐又要高上百万倍。And
these people on the Mahaloka, they are also the first authorities in the to teach about the path of karma.
马哈卢卡上面的这些权威，他们是教导 karma 的权威。
And they worship the Lord of sacrifice. They worship Lord Vishnu as the Lord of sacrifice. And he is personally residing there as their master.
And
so these people on Mahaloka, they very rarely live there, only if they have some very special purpose.
很少离开马哈洛卡，除非是为了特定的目的。They're
already they're perform in their planet Mahaloka. They worship the Supreme Lord by doing sacrifices.
他们在那里是通过祭祀崇拜他们的主人。And
they worship in a more opulent manner than even the demigods in heaven.
他们崇拜的方式。 比起天堂的半神们的崇拜方式更加富裕。So
when Gop Kumar heard about this, then he thought, "Why should I stay here?" Although he was Indra, the king of heaven there, but when he heard about this place above heavenly planets, he wanted to go there. He wanted to see the Lord, see how they worship the Supreme Lord.
Gopakumar 虽然现在已经当上了天堂的鹰主，但是他听说了这些话之后，他就想，为什么我不去那里去看他们的主呢？
So Gop Kumar had seen how the Lord was worshipped on earth, and he thought it was very nice. But then when he went to heaven, he saw it was much better how they worshipped the Lord in more opulence, and it was more attractive.
高帕库马尔在地球上已经见证了地球上的人们是怎样崇拜主的。他又去了天堂，他看到天堂上对主的崇拜呢更加的高级。
So he thought if Mahaloka is above the heavenly planets, he wants to go and see how they worship the Lord there. He knows it must be even greater.
现在呢，他竟然已经听说到了有玛哈洛克的存在，他就想去那里看看那里的人是怎么崇拜主的。
So Gop Kumar began to chant his mantra. He meditated, and he was chanting his mantra. And after some time, an aeroplane came from the higher planets.
Gop Kumar 呢就开始定心的念诵自己的曼陀罗冥想。过了一段时间之后，从更高的星系就降临了一架飞机。
Right, he was chanting his mantra, meditating with the desire, I want to see the Lord of Sacrifice on Mahaloka.
Gopakumar, 他念诵自己的曼陀罗，同时冥想，心里的愿望就是我想要见到 Mahaloka 上的祭祀之主。
So aeroplane came and it took Gop Kumar up to Mahaloka.
一架飞机就来把 Gop Kumar 接到了 Mahaloka.
And when Gop Kumar got there, he saw Bhrigu Muni was there and all the other sages. They had gone to earth and they'd already come back.
到了 Mahaloka 之后， Gop Kumar 在那里就见到了 Bhrigu Muni 还有那些圣人们。他们已经从地球返回了自己的星球。
And when he got there to Mahaloka and he saw, he could feel how everything was so opulent and the worship was so perfect and everyone was so happy.
Gopakumar 到了那时候，他看到了并且感觉到了一切都是那么的富裕，一切都是那么完美，所有的生物都那么快乐。
And the residents, the people who live there on Mahaloka, they never argue with each other.
并且居住在 Mahaloka 上的居民们彼此之间从来不争吵。
They don't suffer any miseries of the material world.
物质世界的这些 Mahaloka 上面的居民们从来没有感受到这个世界上的痛苦。
And for the lower planets in the universe, at the end of Brahma's day, these planets are all annihilated, they're all destroyed. But this higher planet, Mahaloka, is never destroyed.
在 Brahma 的白天结束之际，所有这些低等的星系呢，全归于毁灭。但是 Mahaloka 不会毁灭。
Now on the planets of the demigods sometimes they would quarrel and there would be some kind of competition between them, but on Mahaloka it was not like that.
在天堂，半神们彼此之间有时候会竞争，彼此争吵，但是 Mahaloka 上没有这种事情。
Everybody worshipped the Supreme Lord there without any selfish desire.
在那里，人人都没有任何自私的动机的崇拜至尊主。
And so, because everyone was so pure, so much opulence was, that everything was very wonderful. There was no scarcity. Everything was in abundance.
因为那里的生物是那么的心地纯净，所以那里是一切都非常富裕了，从来不缺，没有任何的物质匮乏。
we can only know about Mahaloka by the mercy of Sanatana Goswami, who wrote this book.
只有藉着Sanatana Goswami 这部书的作者的仁慈，我们才了解到 Mahaloka.
Yeah, we wouldn't know anything about this planet without the mercy of Sanatana Goswami.
没有Sanatana Goswami的仁慈，我们是无从了解这样的信息的。
But we should understand how there are so many higher planets above this planet.
我们要知道，在我们这个星系之上呢，还有那么多的高等星系。
So on Mahaloka, the great sages there, they all have pure devotion, and all the time they're offering sacrifice to the Supreme Lord.
在马哈洛克上的生物们，他们都怀着纯粹的奉爱，为主做祭祀。They
would make the fire, and they would make offerings into the fire, and from the fire, the Lord of Sacrifice, Lord Vishnu, would appear from the fire and accept their offerings.
他们就点燃祭火，向火中供奉祭品，之后。 这个祭祀之主, Vishnu, 就亲自显现了。And
Gop Kumar saw the beautiful form of the Lord. He saw how the Lord would appear and personally accept the offerings of these devotees.
Gop Kumar 就亲眼见到主的这一美丽形体，见到了主 Vishnu 是怎样亲自的接受的祭品。The
great sages like Bhrigu Muni and all of his brothers, they're very pure Vaishnavas, and they only worship Lord Vishnu.
Bhrigu Muni 及其兄弟们都是纯粹的 Vaishnava, 他们只崇拜 Vishnu.
And Lord Vishnu would personally appear and accept their offerings.
而主 Vishnu 也亲身的显现，接受他们的供奉。
So when the Lord would appear, he was very, you know, he's coming from the fire, so he's very brilliant. He's like the sun appearing. And he will accept, they offer this thing called charu. They offer this, rice and dal and butter, and it's cooked in milk, and they make this nectar, and they call it charu, and they offer this to Lord Vishnu.
圣哲们呢，他们所准备的是一种名字叫charu的祭品，是由大米、豆汤、黄油和用牛奶烹制的食物。 做成的这样的一个贡品，名字就叫Charu。
And the Lord Vishnu would appear, and he would accept this, and then he would also give benedictions to all the people who were offering the worship.
主 Vishnu 就会亲身的显现，接受他们的祭品，之后就祝福所有参加祭祀的人们。
So Vedic sacrifices are always performed for the pleasure of for Lord Vishnu.
所有的这些祭祀取悦 Vishnu 而进行的。
So these residents of Mahaloka, this is their business. They're doing this sacrifice every day.
Mahaloka 上的居民，他们的事物就是每一天都举行祭祀。
So, all the parts of the body of Lord Vishnu are very beautiful.
Vishnu's 的身体的各个部位都异常美丽。
Gop Kumar saw the beauty of the Lord, and Gop Kumar always wanted to see the Lord of the universe, and when he saw the Lord appear from the fire, oh, he saw it so beautiful, he was so attracted. And he saw how he accepted the offering, so Gop Kumar felt very satisfied.
现在他见到眼前这位美丽的、有魅力的人，就接受着祭圣人们的祭祀，他感到心满意足。
Gop Kumar had been, he'd had association with Lord Vamanadeva on the heavenly planets, but he saw that this Lord Vishnu on Mahaloka was even more attractive than Lord Vamanadeva.
Gop Kumar 在天堂见到了主 Vamanadeva， 现在他觉得眼前这位Mahaloka 上的祭祀之主比 Vamanadeva 更有吸引力。
So while Gop Kumar was watching the sacrifice, Lord Vishnu took some of the Mahaprasadam and he put it in the hand of Gop Kumar.
Gop Kumar 注视着这个祭祀之祭，祭祀之主亲手就拿起了一些 Mahaprasad 放到了 Gop Kumar 的手中。
So Gop Kumar was always eager, he was always thinking how he could do some service for the Lord. Could he do any personal service? So Lord Vishnu reciprocated.
Gop Kumar 一直渴望能亲身做一些服务，这样一来主就开始回应他了。
And so Lord Vishnu gave him the Mahaprasadam. He said, here, take this.
主 Vishnu 给了他一些 Mahaprasadam， 说道，拿着。
And so Gop Kumar became very ecstatic. He thought, oh, all my desires have now been fulfilled. This must be the highest thing.
Gop Kumar 就处在极乐当中了，心想，哦，我所有的愿望全都满足了，这一定是最了不起的事情了。
Because Gop Kumar, he always wanted to have this.He had this desire to see the Lord and to have this personal exchange with Him. So here on Mahaloka it was happening.
Gop Kumar 长久的愿望就是想见到宇宙之主和宇宙之主亲身的交流。现在在 Mahaloka 上，他的这个愿望终于实现了。
So Gop Kumar became a resident. He began to live there on Mahaloka. He didn't want to leave.And he was in the association of great sages. And wherever he would go, he'd visit different homes. He saw everywhere they're doing the yajna, and the Lord of the universe would be there and come and accept their offerings.
Gop Kumar 已经成为了詹达，就是 Mahaloka 的居民。他也不想离开那里。他与圣人们为伴，他会去拜访不同圣人们家中。家家户户都会举行 yagya 祭祀，而主 Vishnu 会亲自接受他们的供奉。
So Gop Kumar thought, yeah, I'll just stay here. This is everything is here. The Lord is here. I can see the Lord every day.
Gop Kumar 就想，我就留在这儿了。祭祀之主就在这里，我能天天见到他。
He thought, here I'm getting the mercy of the Lord.
我在这里正得到着主的仁慈。
But one time, after he'd been staying there for some time, the great sages said to him that we want to make you a brahmana. We want to, because you're a cowherd boy just now, but we want you to become a brahmana. And we'll make you a brahmana so that you can stay on this planet.It would be good for you to be a brahmana. So, you please become like us. We will make you brahmana.
过了一段时间，圣哲们就对 Gop Kumar 说：“我们想把你变成 brahmana， 因为你是一位牧牛童，照料母牛的。现在呢，我们希望你也成为 brahmana， 待在这里。”
Gop Kumar, he was just from a village in Govardhan. He's a Vaishya.He's not a brahmana, he was a Vaishya. His family would just take care of cows. Now the Vaishyas can also be initiated. They can also receive the sacred thread.
Gop Kumar 来自 Govardhan 山的一个村子，那里的人们都照料着母牛。Vaishya 们也能得到二次启 启迪, 获得圣献。
Brahmana, Kshatriyas, and Vaishyas, they all get Vedic initiation and education, so they chant that they can all chant the Gayatri Mantra.
Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, 都可以接受伟大教育，获得伟大启迪，启迪 唱诵 Gayatri Mantra.
But Gopkumar was just from a village in Govardhan, and they didn't worry about these things, so he'd never got education, he had never been initiated, and he'd been illiterate.
Gopakumar 从来不担心这个伟大教育，也不去想什么启迪的事情，他就是一个文盲。
So he thought, I'm not even a Vaishya, how can I be initiated to become a Brahmana?
他心想，我连Vaishya都算不上，我怎么能得到启迪成为Brahmana呢？
Of course, the sages were very powerful. They could do it. They wanted him to change his dress because he's still dressed like a cowherd boy.
圣哲们是特别有力量的，他们想改变Gopakumar的衣着，因为Gopakumar的衣着呢，还是一个牧牛童的衣，牧牛郎的衣着。
So they asked him, you become a sage like us, and you can also perform sacrifice for the Lord of the Universe.
圣哲们对他说，你也跟我们一样，像我们一样，成为我们中的一员，这样你就可以举行祭祀，崇拜祭祀之主，宇宙之主。
But Gopkumar said, no, I'm happy just to be a Vaishya. I just want to stay as I am, a cowherd boy. I'm just a Vaishya. Because if I stay as I am, then I can enjoy watching the Supreme Lord and also watch you people, how you worship the Lord.
Gopakumar 回答说, 哦，我现在当一个Vaishya，我做一个牧牛童，我感到很满意，很高兴。这样我就可以看着你们怎么去崇拜至尊主。Now
I can worship the Lord, and I can also worship you because you're the Brahmanas.
我不仅能崇拜至尊主，我也能崇拜你们，因为你们都是Brahmana。But
if I become a Brahmana, I won't be able to be a servant anymore because I'll be the Brahmana and people will be serving me.
但我要是做了Brahmana的话，我就不能当仆人了，因为别人这样反过来就要来服我。
Well, but if I stay a Vaishya, I can keep serving I can serve you and I can also worship the Supreme Lord.
如果我继续做一名Vaishya的话，我就可以继续来崇拜你们，同时也能够崇拜至尊主。I
just want to stay the servant.
我只是想当一名仆人。Not
everybody wants to be the big Brahmana or the big person. Gopkumar is very humble.
不是每个人都想当了不起的Brahmana大人物，Gopakumar只是一个非常谦卑的人。
So Gopkumar, he was thinking, for the Brahmanas, the only thing they have in life is performing the sacrifice for the Lord.
Gopakumar 想，对于Brahmana，他们的生活就是一味地为主做祭祀。
But I have my mantra to chant, given to me by my guru, and I shouldn't neglect that. I don't want to stop chanting the mantra which my guru gave me.
可是我的guru还给了我一首 mantra 来念诵，我不想忽视我的guru的命令，停止念诵 mantra。
Gopkumar already saw the power of the guru's mantra, because by the power of the guru's mantra, he'd gone to heaven and he'd become Indra, the king of heaven.
Gopakumar 见证着这首 mantra 的力量，藉着这个 mantra， 他可以当上天堂的 Indra。
And also now the mantra had also brought him to Mahaloka, and he's living on Mahaloka, which was a very difficult place to reach. And so he told the sages, no, I'm sorry, I don't want to be a Brahmana. I'm just stay as I am.
告诉这些圣者们，很抱歉，我不想当 Brahmana， 我就想保持现在的这个样子。
But he stayed on that planet Mahaloka, enjoying the pleasures of that planet.
但是他还留在 Mahaloka， 享受着那里的快乐。
There was nothing wrong. No faults were there. There was no sadness, no sorrow, no doubt.
在 Mahaloka 上，既没有错误，也没有悲伤，也没有疑惑。
There were constant festivals performing yagya for the pleasure of the Lord.
那里就是恒常的，每天都在举行着节日。
Gop Kumar had seen on the heavenly planets. When he was on the heavenly planets, he saw lust sometimes, and he saw how sometimes they'd be angry and they'd be proud.
Gop Kumar 去过天堂，他看到那里也有色欲，也有愤怒，还有骄傲。
But on Mahaloka, there was no problem, nothing like that. There was no fault.
然而在 Mahaloka 却不存在所有这一切，没有任何错误。
They were not afraid of anything. They had no anxiety.
他们无需担心，也没有任何焦虑。
Their whole day was just spent worshiping the Lord, performing sacrifice every day.
他们会一整天都崇拜，至尊主，并且做祭祀。
They had no interest at all in.Mundane sense gratification.
他们对于世俗的感官性享乐没有丝毫的兴趣。
But at the end of it, when they would perform their sacrifice, at the end of the sacrifice, then some unhappiness would come because after the sacrifice, then the Lord would disappear.
然而当祭祀举行完之后，就有一些令人不高兴的事情发生了，因为主就会离开。
And then when they would start another sacrifice, then the Lord would appear again.
当另外一次祭祀举行的时候，主又再次显现。
Because the Lord is controlled by the love of his devotees.
主被他的奉献者的爱所控制着。
So he would not be invisible for long. He would disappear for some time. Then as soon as he began another sacrifice, he would come.
So he 主不会长时间的让人看不到自己，但有另外一场祭祀举行的时候，他又再次显现。
But this for Gop Kumar, this was a problem. He didn't like that the Lord would disappear. He wanted the Lord to be visible all the time.
Kumar 不喜欢这样子，他希望能一直见到至尊主，不希望至尊主消失。
Also, at the end of the day of Brahma, that's one day of Brahma, which means 1,000 cycles of the four yugas. Then the three worlds, there would be some devastation.
而且呢，在 Brahma 的一天，结束的时候 ，Brahma 的一天就是四个年代总和乘以一千，在这个时间过去之后，三个世界都处在毁灭当中。
The Mahaloka is near to the heavenly planets.
Mahaloka.
It's above, but it's near.
Mahaloka 呢？比天堂要高一点，但离天堂很近。
So when there's a fire of the annihilation at the end of Brahma's day, then the higher people from Mahaloka they have to go because they feel the heat from the fire. So they go up to the next planet. They go up to Jhanaloka, the higher planet above Mahaloka.
当下面燃烧起毁灭之火时，马哈洛卡上的居民们就挪到比他们更高的詹纳洛卡上。
So when Gop Kumar had to go up to Janaloka, he saw it was just like night time. There were no sacrifices being performed, and the Lord was not present.
Gopal Kumar, he 到了 Janaloka 上的时候，正好是夜晚。这时候呢，既没有祭祀，也见不到祭祀之主。
So Gop Kumar felt very uncomfortable there because he's not able to see the Lord.
Gopal Kumar 就觉得在那里待着不舒服，因为他见不到主。
So he thought, maybe I should go back to Jagannath Puri because in Jagannath Puri I can see the Lord there all the time.
他心想，也许我现在要回扎格纳普瑞，因为我在扎格纳普瑞呢，什么时候都能见到至尊主。
But then he thought even better than Jagannath Puri is go to Vrindavan.
但是他觉得比扎格纳普瑞更好的是回到 Vrindavan.
Whenever he would chant his mantra, he would think about Vrindavan and he would remember the beauty of Vrindavan and he'd want to go back to Vrindavan. So within the heart of Gop Kumar, he always has this deep attachment to Vrindavan. He's always thinking about how nice to be a cowherd boy, just to be with the cows and Govardhan Hill.
他的内心深深地依恋着文达文的美丽，那依恋着那里的母牛，还有 Govardhan 山。
So even though he was going to these opulent places, very exalted, special places in the universe, he could not forget Vrindavan.
即便他去了那些富裕的地方，那些崇拜至尊主的特殊的崇高的地方，他也念念不忘文达文。
He could forget sometimes about Jagannath Puri, but he could not forget Vrindavan.
他可以忘掉扎格纳普瑞，但是他忘不掉扎格文达文。
But then at that time, then the Lord would appear to him, and the Lord of sacrifice would appear, and he would call him, and he would give him attention and he would bring pleasure to the heart of Gop Kumar.
但是主他有时候会，祭祀之主有时候会显现给 Gop Kumar， 跟他打招呼，并且关心他，给他的内心带来快乐。
Whatever Gop Kumar would offer to the Lord would happily accept it.
无论 Gop Kumar 给主给什么供奉，主都会欣然接受。
So Gop Kumar thought, how can I leave here? I cannot leave here. I'm so fortunate to be here with the Lord.
Gop Kumar 内心就开始斗争了。我怎么能离开这里呢？我这么幸运能够来到这儿。
So during the night, when he could not see the Lord, it was painful. But then when the day would come, then he would be able to see the Lord again and the pain would go away.
每当夜晚降临，见不到主的时候，勾帕库马尔就感到异常的痛苦。而白天一旦来临，他见到主，他又再次高兴起来。
And so when during the day they would do sacrifice, and the Lord would come and take the offerings, it would be a festival again. So Gop Kumar would feel happiness again.
所以每当白天的时候，就会有祭祀，就像一场节日一样。Gop Kumar 就会再次高兴。
So in this way, Gop Kumar became happy again in the higher planets.
就这样 ，Gop Kumar 在高等星系就会再次内心感到很喜悦。
But while he was residing there, then somebody else came from a higher planet, and this time this personality was.He was very effulgent, and his body was not covered with any cloth, And he appeared just to be like a 5 or 6 year old boy.
Kumar 就在那里的时候呢，又来了一个人。这个人呢，他光彩夺目，他的躯体呢没有任何衣服，他显得就像一个五六岁的男孩。
So sometimes the people from Mahaloka they would go to Janaloka, right? There's not much difference. There's one difference only between the two planets.
有的时候马哈洛卡上的居民会去詹纳洛卡，这两个星系呢区别不大。
The difference is that Janaloka is further away, so they don't have to worry about the heat or the fire which comes from the lower planets.
唯一的区别呢，就是詹纳洛卡，比下面的星系要更遥远，因此在那里就感受不到低等星系。毁灭之际的热量。
But there's another planet above Janaloka that's called Tapaloka, and now Gop Kumar is going to hear about Tapaloka.
在 Janaloka 之上还有另外一个高等的星系叫 Tapaloka, 现在 Gop Kumar 就会聆听到有关 Tapaloka 的事。
And so the person who had come with, you know, he appears to be like a 5-year-old child. So it's not uncommon, you know, little children, the mother may not dress them. The children run around without clothes on. Nobody takes any offense. They see the little child without any clothes.
那来的这一位呢，就像五岁的小男孩一样。如果五岁的小男孩呢，他的妈妈不给他穿衣服，他跑来跑去，光着身子，也没有人会觉得内心不舒服。
So when this personality appeared, all the great sages, they put down their sacrificial instruments, all the things they're using to do the yagya, and they all stood up and they bowed down to this little boy.
当所有圣人们看到这位五岁大的男孩降显现的时候，他们都纷纷放下手中的祭祀工具，起立向他致以顶拜。
The little boy was in meditation, but all the great sages were worshipping him as if he was the Lord of the sacrifice.
这位小男孩处在深深的冥想当中，然而所有的圣哲们崇拜他，就像崇拜他们的祭祀之主。
So after some time, then the little boy, this child, he just disappeared. He went away. So then Gop Kumar asked all the great sages, who was that? Where did he come from?
过了一阵子，这个五岁大的男孩就消失了。Gop Kumar 就开始发问，他是谁？他从哪里来？
Why, and Gop Kumar saw they were worshipping him. So Gop Kumar asked him, why are your great sages are worshipping this little boy?
Gop Kumar 看到圣人们就这样崇拜他，就又问，你们为什么要崇拜他呢？
So then the sages said, that person was Sanat Kumar. He is the most senior, he's the oldest amongst all of us, and he's the greatest.
圣哲们回答道，他的名字叫 Sanat Kumar, 他是较年长。
So we're going to hear about him tomorrow, the next class. We'll go on and hear more about Sanat Kumar.
下一节课，我们就继续聆听有关于 Gopa Kumar Sanat Kumar 的事情。
Are there any questions today?
Yes.
Good day. 那个上周因为停电，我们还剩了两个问题没有回答。我们是先回答今天的，还是上一周的？
上一周的，对。
好的，看一下。 上周，Vedavati Madhaji Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru 感恩翻译，请问 Guru Vishnu 为什么不能像主家跟他那样待在一个地方呢？
Vishnu,
How can why cannot Vishnu stay in one place?
Why Jagannath? Yeah.
Yes. It's because at the end of the class you said
Oh,
the
okay. I know. Okay, I've got it. Yeah. Because Vishnu was appearing as the Lord of sacrifice. So when they do the sacrifice, he would come and he'd take the offerings, and then after taking the offering, then we would go.
因为每当举行祭祀的时候呢，维什奴作为祭祀之主就会显现接受祭品，而每当这个接受完之后呢，他就走了。
But Lord Jagannath is the deity. The deity is always there.
但神像总在那儿。
Deity remains as in that one place.
神像就会一直待在一个地方。
Usually, some special time, some special pastime, he may go with a devotee, but usually the deity will stay on the altar in the temple.
一般而言呢，神像就会待在这个庙里的神坛上。除了某些特定的例子之外，他会跟着奉献者。
But the Lord of Sacrifice, he comes to receive the offerings. When we do the yajna, that time he will come and he will accept the offering. And then after taking the offering, when the yajna is finished, then he will go.
然而，每当就是举行祭祀，向火中供奉祭品的时，
And similarly, on the heavenly planets, it was
对。
Lord Vamanadeva.
Yeah.
On the heavenly planets, it was Lord Vamanadeva, and Lord Vamanadeva would sometimes go to different places. Sometimes he'd go different, visit different places. Sometimes he'd go to Dhruvaloka. Sometimes he will have to go and see different people.
在天堂上，是主 Vamanadeva 的临在，他有时候会拜访各个。有时候会去拜访 Dhruvaloka。
Sometimes he'll go with Lakshmi, he'll take his wife somewhere and go somewhere.
他有时候带着他的妻子 Lakshmi 就去别的地方。
So Gop Kumar, while he was in the heavenly planets, he saw that sometimes Lord Vishnu is there, sometimes he's not there.
哥帕库马尔在天堂的时候，有时候能见到他，但有时候又见不到他。
So he was feeling that problem. He wanted to see the Lord all the time.
问题就在于他是一直都想要见到主。
But the Lord has his own independence. Sometimes he will come, sometimes he will go.
主他有自己的独立性，他有的时候来，有的时候走。
But of course, there's some special features when you have the Lord personally there, that you know, for like Gop Kumar was offering things, the Lord would accept. Sometimes the Lord would give his Mahaprasadam to Gop Kumar. So these things didn't happen with the deity so much.
当主他亲身临在的时候呢，他会亲自接受，贡品。他有时候呢，又把马哈普沙的给予格巴库玛。然而神像呢，他会一直就待在那儿。
Okay, another question.
下一个问题是那个 Samasaki Madhaji, Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru, 请问 Gopa Kumar 既然得到主加班纳的亲自与他对话，又到了 Vrindavan, 为什么不想去见主 Krishna 本人呢？而是去了天堂星宿。他思念 Vrindavan 的时候，主 Vishnu 为什么不让他回到 Vrindavan 完成他的心愿，却安慰他去了天堂星宿呢？主 Vishnu 是想让 Gopal Kumar 发展。
Well,
Krishna 的心态吧。
Can you translate first, Guruman?
Yeah, because last class you mentioned, when Gopal Kumar sometimes Galoka, at that time, the Lord will pacify him and say nice words to him. Her question is that. Why the Lord wants Gopal Kumar to stay in the heavenly planets instead of encouraging him to go back to Vrindavan to develop the mood of Go?
Okay, so when the Lord got to the heavenly planets, there was some service for him to do. They needed someone to take the place of Indra. So Gopal Kumar got that opportunity to do some service for the Lord.
Because Gopal Kumar, he in the heavens, has a service to do. Because the Lord wants him to do some service there, to take the place of Indra in the heavens.
And we see also Sanatana Goswami, he has written this book in such a way so that we can all get information about life on these other different planets in the universe.
Sanatana Goswami 撰著这本书的这样的方法，就是给我们不同宇宙星系的信息，好让我们对宇宙有所了解。
Because if we just simply hear about Vrindavan, we may always be thinking, oh, Vrindavan's okay, but I think the higher planets must be better. So we get information about the different faults. What are the problems in these different places, and why the best place is Vrindavan?
We 就对于这些星系上面的一些缺点有所了解，最后得出结论就是 Vrindavan 是最好的地方。
Yeah, after you've been to all the other places, then you'll know that Vrindavan is the best place. But if you just go to Vrindavan, you don't know about the other places. You don't know about the faults there.
在去完宇宙的各个星系，对这个各个星系有所了解，知道每个星系上各自的缺陷之后，我们就了解 Vrindavan 的地位了。不然的话，我们就不知道 Vrindavan 是最高的地方。
We are always thinking, oh, there's something better, some other place. Hare Krishna.
Okay, 然后是今天的问题了。
Okay.
连拜神人都有嫉妒心，看来嫉妒是很难克服的。怎么才能尽快地清除嫉妒呢？
How to get rid of envy? Even in the demigods, they have enviousness. And how can we get rid of envy?
As soon as possible.
As soon as possible, okay. So we get rid of envy by doing pure devotional service. By cultivating the mood of pure devotional service, then all the bad qualities can be removed. The demigods, while they are great devotees, they're not yet pure devotees.
虽然是奉献给主了，然而并不纯粹。
But they do great service on behalf of the Lord, and they're very dear to the Lord. So we respect them.
他们代表主从事服务，主非常对他们非常亲切，所以我们也尊重他们。
But they have some material desires, and it comes out in the form of this envy.
然而，他们内心还有物质欲望，就是。
So we can get rid of.
形式显现出来了。
We can get rid of this envy by simply focusing on devotional service and becoming pure in our own service to Krishna.
我们可以通过专注于奉献服务来去除嫉妒，让我们的服务变得纯粹。
All the good qualities come by doing devotional service.
所有的美好品质透过奉献服务都自动的发展出来。
Next question.
下一个问题，
仆人的问题，请问咕噜，圣地、圣河、圣人哪一个净化力更大？如果这一世没有机会去圣地，是不是就得不到完美的净化了？
If we don't go to the holy place, then we cannot get purified.
The holy dam, holy river, and holy man, if we cannot have the chance to go there, so
cannot get full purification.
We cannot.
Gonna get full purification.
Perfection.
Perfection. Yeah. Okay. Well, the Holy Dham. Prabhupada said he thought it's good at least once in a lifetime we should try to visit the Holy Dham.
是的，爸爸说过，我们这一生至少。
If we're not able even once to visit the Holy Dham, still the Holy Dham has come to us in the form of Krishna consciousness.
即便我们这一生连一次也去不了圣地的话，那我们也不用担心，因为圣地是以 Krishna 之觉的形式来到我们这里了。
And people who go to the Holy Dham, they can bring you the water.From the holy river.
而去过圣地的人们可以从圣地带来圣河的水。
They can bring you the dust from the holy dam.
也可以带回来圣地的尘土。
And they can bring you also the prasadam from the holy dam.
也可以带来圣地的 prasadam.
And we are able to watch all the activities of the holy dam by means of the.Telecommunication, the internet, and so on. We can see pictures, we can see videos, we can see all the activities.
We can see the internet, the internet, and the activities.
So you can get all perfection, even in your own home.
你在自己的家里也可以得到全部的保护。
You have tulsi, you can keep the tulsi tree there in your home.
你可以在家中就是崇拜 tulsi. His question is that the holy dam, holy river, and the holy man, which is more purifying? The power of purifying, which is more?
The holy man.Is more purifying.
那在圣地、圣河、圣人当中，圣人更有净化力。
Because the holy man can purify you immediately, but the holy river, you bathe in the holy river, you have to bathe many times to get purified.
圣人可以立刻就净化人。但是要在圣河当中沐浴许多次才可以得到净化。
But the holy man can purify you quickly, very quickly.
圣人可以很快的就能够使你得到进步。
圣人、圣河还有什么
？Holy Dham.
The Holy Dham, yeah. Okay, so the man, the holy Shenren is the man, the holy man is more powerful, the most powerful.
在圣地、圣和、圣人当中呢，圣人是最有力量的，进化力最强的。
下一个问题，马哈洛卡的居民看上去是纯粹的奉献者，为什么他们还没有达到灵性世界呢？
It sounds that the residents of Mahaloka is are pure devotees. Why they don't go to
They have to wait. Haribo. Yeah, they have to wait for the end of the life of Brahma. At the end of the life of Brahma, at that time, then they can go. They're busy doing their devotional service. They're already back to Godhead in a sense. They're already qualified. They're liberated in this very life. It's not that they have to go back to Godhead immediately. In this life, we can be liberated.
他们忙着做服务，就在某种意义上，他们已经是回归灵性世界的，他们有这个资格回归灵性世界了。
At the end of Brahma's life, they will go back to Godhead.
在 Brahma
的一生结束之后，他们就可以回灵性世界。下一个问题。好的，下一个问题是，西宝说巴扎马达基的问题，明白咕噜翻译。感恩咕噜通过经典带给我们灵性世界的奉爱生活。今天的问题是。 有一位妈妈在做手术前一直念诵圣名，结果在濒死体验中跟随 Krishna 的笛声去了一个非常美，莲花儿鸟都唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，在那里。后来因为想起了儿子，又回到了躯体当中。请问，就是这位妈妈因为她刚刚接触 Krishna 知觉。 然后还在吃肉，如果是这样的人一直唱诵圣名，能不能保证在死亡的时候回到灵性世界呢？
No. You want to translate the full question?
Yeah. Yes. The question is that there is a Mataji. He has been chanting the holy name before the operation. Thereafter, in her near-death experience, she followed the flute sound of Krishna. She went to a very beautiful place where even the flowers and birds are chanting the name of Krishna. And Mataji, as soon as she remembers her son, she returned back to the body. The question is that the Mataji is just got contact with Bhakti Yoga and still eating meat. So if she continues chanting the holy name, is it an assurance that in the real death comes, she can return back to the spiritual world?
Well, before she can go back to the spiritual world, she has to stop eating meat. Before she can go back to the spiritual world, she will have to stop eating meat.
Okay. 在她回到灵性世界之前，必须要停止吃肉。
In order to go to the spiritual world, she has to fully purify herself of the material desires.
在她回到灵性世界之前，必须要
So Krishna is giving her some taste, Krishna is giving her some experience, but she's not yet ready
Krishna 给他了一些品味，让他有了一些体验，但他现在还没有做好回去的准备。
So she has to get ready, she has to become serious, and she has to stop all the sinful activities.
她必须要自己做好准备，变得非常的真诚，停止所有的罪恶活动。
And she has to become attached to Krishna.
她必须要依附 Krishna.
Not just to her son, but she has to see Krishna in the heart of her son.
而不是依附她的儿子。他应该在他儿子的心中能够看到 Krishna。
Yeah, OK. 还有问题吗？
是的，还有问题。不如永恒的在永恒的在 Sadasiva， 在物质世界，主希瓦是否也有一个居住的星球？是什么地方？
Does Shiva have a planet?
Yes, in the material world.
If Shiva has a planet, it's called Kailash. It's a
Shiva 的
Yeah.
Shiva 的地方叫 Kailash.
It's between the material and spiritual world.
介于物质世界和灵性之间。
So Lord Shiva resides there.
主 Shiva 居住在 Kailash。
下一个问题。Yamuna Tira， 顶白古鲁，超灵居于众生心中，那么物质世界超灵有没有一个固定居住的星球呢？
Obeisances to Guru and the super soul reside in the heart of the living entities. Are there any fixed residence, fixed planets in the material world for the super soul?
Well, Shirodakshayi Vishnu is the super soul, and Shirodakshayi Vishnu has Sweta Dweep.And he resides on Sweta Dweep, the island Sweta Dweep. Surrounded by the milk ocean. So that's where you could say the super soul was there.
你可以说超灵就居住在这里。
OK， 还有问题吗？
我说还有三个问题呢。
好。
OK， free and easy， 就是感谢咕噜的精彩讲课和翻译。今天讲的 Gopal Kumar。在 Mahaloka 的经历让我心潮澎湃，太甜美了。第一个问题， Mahaloka 在宇宙的什么位置？我反观自己的生活正好相反，我在痛苦时意念主可积极了，但好的情况就觉得自己是自己努力的结果。这是第一个问题。
She's very excited by your lecture, wonderful lecture today. The story of Gopal Kumar in Mahaloka, and the question is that, where is this Mahaloka in the universe? This is the first part.
Mm-hmm. So Mahaloka is above the heavenly planet.Right, we're the earthly planet. The earthly planet is in the middle of the universe.
我们居住的是地球，处在宇宙的中央。
Below the earthly planet, you've got the lower regions, and you go down to the hellish planets.
在地 球之下是低等的区域，甚至可以去地狱。
And above the earthly planets, you come up, you can go up to the heavenly planets.
而在地球之上，可以晋升到天堂。
The demigods living there in the heavenly planets.
天堂上居住的都是半神人们。
But above the heavenly planets, some other planets. Mahaloka is the first one you come to above the heavenly planet.
在天堂之上呢是其他的星系，第一个呢就是 Mahaloka。
And above Mahaloka, then we have Janaloka。
在 Mahaloka 之上，我们有 Janaloka。
And above Janaloka, the Tapoloka。
在 Janaloka 之上是
Tapoloka。
Tapoloka。
And above Tapoloka, we have Brahmaloka.
在 Tapoloka 之上是 Brahmaloka.
So this is the universe.
这就是宇宙的结构。
下一个问题。
The next is that she continues with the question. When I was in the difficulty and I felt very painful.I'm very active in remembering the Lord, but as soon as the situation gets better, I felt that the situation is all due to my own endeavor, my own, I work hard. I felt it's the result of my endeavoring. So the question is that how can I taste the nectar of the happiness comes from the Lord?She pay obeisance to you.
How can she taste the nectar from the Lord?
How can she realize that all the happiness and all the sweetness is coming from the Lord instead of her own endeavoring? And how can she change her mind that only...she remembers the Lord only in difficult.
Okay. Yeah, so you have
to look her.
Yeah, you have to do more hearing and chanting.
你需要更多的聆听和念诵。
You have to understand devotional service is not something which you just do when you have difficulty, but you should do it every day.
您要明白，不是说在困难的时候才做奉献服务，而是您要每天都要做奉献服务。
We don't just only think of Krishna when we're in difficulty, but we think of Krishna every day.
我们不是等到困难的时候才想起 Krishna, 而是每天都要想 Krishna.
Think of Krishna every moment.
片片刻刻的想着 Krishna.
Don't just wait only.Hare Bol.
Hare Krishna, good day.
我们跟有停电，对不起。
是的，是的，有奉献者告诉我们又停电了。好，那我们可以继续吗？
对 ，Yeah, we're talking about the lady who only thinks of Krishna when she's in distress. So maybe she needs to pray to Krishna to give her more distress or give her distress all the time. Then she can remember Krishna.
刚才呢，我们谈到了那个女士，她只是在困难的时候才想起 Krishna， 所以呢，也许她应该向 Krishna 祈祷，让她一直都很困难，这样她能时时刻刻能想到主。
One solution. 还有问题吗？
还有。三句我这又看不到了，哎，看看
到吗？
没有。
Mahaloka， 关于大慈的问题，看，Mahaloka， 第二。 点吗？
It sounds that Mahaloka is very perfect. Are there any defect in Mahaloka?
Well, the problem for Gop Kumar was that the Lord he just comes and takes the offerings and then he goes. After, when they're not doing sacrifice, the Lord is not present.
对于 Gopa Kumar 来说呢，就是主只是来接受供奉，那接受完供奉呢，他就离开了，就祭祀结束了，他就离开了，他又见不到主。
So that is the one problem which, and Gopa Kumar sees everybody there is a Brahmana, and they're just simply doing the rituals every, do the yagya, Vedic sacrifice every day.
其实在 Mahaloka 上的全部都是 Brahmana 们，他们都在从事着这些仪式，从事着做与伟达的祭祀。
So Gopa Kumar said he didn't want to do that. He said he's not a Brahmana. He said he's a Vaishya. He's a cowherd boy.
Gopa Kumar 不想那么做，他觉得自己是一个 Vaishya， 属于 Vaishya 阶层，是属于牧牛童。
He just wants to be the servant.
他只想做仆人。
He wants to serve the Brahmanas.
他想服务 Brahmana。
And although Mahaloka is very opulent, it doesn't have the quite the sweetness of Vrindavan. The sweetness of Vrindavan is more attractive.
而 Vrindavan 的甜美相比 Mahaloka 的富裕来说是更有吸引力的。
How you went to?
下一个问题 ，Radha Priya， 顶拜 Guru 的莲花族，今天的课程中 ，Gopa Kumar 因为谦卑不想成为婆罗门，这是因为他原本的地位就是牧牛童吗？还是他并不在意的身份，而是只想着 Krishna 并服务他的奉献者呢？感谢 Guru。
So out of humbleness, Gopa Kumar.Didn't want to become a Brahmana. Is that due to his own sarup, his identification?
Yes. Gopa Kumar. Well, he liked to give service. He thought if he becomes a Brahmana, then he will have a different relationship with the other Brahmanas. And he liked to just simply be the servant, to serve the Brahmanas and to see them as his superiors. He didn't like to be there, to be on an equal level with them. He was taking more satisfaction and pleasure in being the servant.
如果要是成为了 Brahmana 的话，与这些婆罗门的 Brahmana 的关系呢就改变了。他想把这些 Brahmana 呢当做自己的高等权威，他不想跟这些 Brahmana 处在同一层面上。他现在的地位呢，他觉得自己就已经很快乐了，就做他们的仆人。
And he's still attached to Vrindavan in his heart. He's remembering also Vrindavan.
心呢一直就依恋文达文，他一直在想着文达文。
So he doesn't want to change anything.
所以他不希望有什么变化。
Not everybody likes to be respected and have people bow down before them and honor them. Some people they just like to be unnoticed.
不是每个人都希望得到别人的尊重，被别人顶拜，获得赞誉。他们有的时候，他们就不想引人注目。
So Gopa Kumar is a bit like that.
Gopa Kumar 就是有点这样。
He's happy to be the servant. How you went, Ima?
Priya， 感故人的精彩讲课。灵性导师说，即便我们想得到一丁点的尊重，我们都必须要在物质世界继续投生。圣恩帕布帕德说，我们达到70%的完美，今生就可以回归了。请问古鲁如何正确理解这两种不同的说法？
There are two things. Our spiritual master said, as long as we have a tinge of material desires, we have to take birth. And Srila Prabhupada said, if we get perfection, 70% perfection, we can go back. So how to...
Understand, okay. How do we understand these two things? Well,
yes.
Prabhupada said, if we don't have 100% perfection, we're not free of material desires. But if we hold on to Srila Prabhupada's lotus feet, or if we hold on to Prabhupada's dhoti, then Prabhupada would pull us back to Godhead.
Srila Prabhupada 说过，我们如果还有物质欲望，但是如果我们紧紧抓住灵性导师的莲花足，抓住灵性导师的兜体，灵性导师就可以把我们带回灵性世界。
So if we hold on to the feet of the pure devotee, they're completely pure. They can drag us back to Godhead.
如果我们紧紧握住纯粹奉献者的足，莲花足，因为纯粹奉献者是纯粹的，他们把我们带回灵性世界。
But if you don't hold on to Prabhupada's feet, then you have to be 100% pure to go back to Godhead.
如果不能紧紧抓住舍勒帕帕德的莲花足，那么就得自己100%的纯净才能回到灵性世界。
Okay, so that's how we understand these two statements.
所以我们就是这样来理解这两种说法。
Both are possible.
这两种都是可能的。
Okay, so thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Good day. 我们还有两个问题，您时间方便吗？
Okay, good.
乐逍遥，顶拜咕噜翻译。如果每天念诵尼星哈祷文，假如到了外昆塔，会是主尼星哈的形象吗？或者说能不能到尼星哈的这个星宿去？
He asked if we chant the prayer to Lord Nishinadev after we go back to Vaikuntha Loka, our rupa is that the same of Lord Nishinadev?This is the first part. The second part is that. 第二部分是什么内容？
就是他能不能到这个尼星哈的这个星宿？
哦、oh, ，Yeah. The second part is that if he chants the prayer to Lord Nishinadev, can he go back to the local of Lord Nishinadev?
Well.Lord Nrisimhadev is Vishnu, so Lord Vishnu, we can go to Lord Vishnu's planet, Vaikuntha, there's many planets. And Prahlad Maharaj, he's a devotee of Lord Vishnu.
Prahlad Maharaj is 主 Nrisimhadev 的一位奉献者。
So we don't become Lord Nrisingadev, we don't get a form like Lord Nrisingadev, but we simply go there as a devotee, just like Prahlad Maharaj is a devotee of Lord Nrisingadev. So we can also, if we go to the spiritual world, then we'll have a form of a devotee.
我们回到主尼沙德夫的形象，我们就像布拉德马拉什那样，他是主尼沙德夫奉献者，我们也有一个奉献者的形象。
In the spiritual world, four-armed form.
灵性世界是四臂形象。
Can have a form like Lord Vishnu, like Lord Narayan.
可以就是跟主Vishnu、主Narayan的形体一样。
You don't have to be half lion, half man.
不需要就是半人半狮的形象。
What's the second part again?
The second part.
Oh. Live on the same planet.
The second part is that if he chants the prayer of Lord Nrisingadev, can he go back to the local of Lord Nrisingadev?
Well, it's not just chant the prayer, but you have to develop pure love for the Lord.
不仅仅是念诵祷文的问题，还要发展出对主的纯爱。
You have to have pure love, then you go back to Godhead. It's not just only reciting the prayer will help us to develop pure love, but you have to develop we have to get rid of material desire.
唱诵祷文可以帮助我们发展出纯爱。
If you want to go into the spiritual world, you have to be pure.
想要进入灵性世界，必须要纯净。
So that means giving up the material.
Sorry, Mark?
Means we have to give up the material and hold on to the spiritual.
就是我们要放弃物质，要紧紧抓住灵性。
好的，Guru，有一位新朋友问：个体灵魂之间有爱情吗？ 只能和 Krishna 才有爱情吗？
Are there any love affairs between individual souls? Is that the loving affair is only between Jiva and Krishna?
Yes, right. Only between Krishna. Only between the Lord and his devotees. But at the same time in the spiritual world we hear that, you know, there's also husbands and wives. And there's gopis and there's men and women and they may be all together. But they both love the Lord. They're not infatuated with the material body.
Because
we are conditioned souls, these things that are a bit difficult for us to understand.
我们现在还是受条件限制的灵魂，要理解这一点有点困难。But
you have to hear about this more, and you can understand what is pure love.
您需要更多的聆听，以便理解什么是纯爱。Pure
love means there's no lust.
纯爱，纯粹的爱，它就是没有色欲、物质欲望。We
don't have much experience of that in this material world.
我们在这个物质世界对于纯爱没有什么体验。
OK, Hare Krishna.
下一个问题，亚莫纳提拉玛达吉，他继续问，就是关于主希瓦，他在这个物质世界有没有一个固定的居所？另外，太阳神居住在哪儿？太阳星球是属于哪一个界的？
啊。
This Mataji continued to ask, are there any fixed residence for Lord Shiva in this material world? And beside that, the sun planet belong to which planet system?
Sun planet belongs to which planet? The sun planet is a heavenly planet. It's a higher planet, a heavenly planet.Yeah, it's one of the heavenly planets. To go to the sun planet or the moon planet, you have to have pious activities.
太阳属于天堂星宿的其中之一，就像月亮一样，都是天堂星宿的之一。要去那里呢，必须有虔诚活动。
Lord Shiva, yeah, he has a place. There's some.Like there's one place here on this planet, you know, they say the Ganges comes down on the head of Lord Shiva.
至于您的那个第前面那个问题，在物质世界居所，恒河是透过主 Shiva 的头来到了这个物质世界。
Maybe Gangotri.Up in the Himalayas is one place here called Gangotri, means the source of the Ganga, where the Ganga comes from. Maybe Lord Shiva is there.
Yes, the Gangotri, 就是在喜马拉雅山顶的 Gangotri, 那里是恒河的源头。
So maybe Shiva is there. And maybe there's another place which is in China, it's a holy place.Associated with Lord Shiva, and there's a mountain there, and they say Lord Shiva is there.
嗯 ，Mar, there's a little broken. You mentioned that Lord in China there's a place, and then
yeah, there's a holy place. You have to go through You can go from Lhasa, I think, they go up to Lhasa, and then you have to trek for several days. And there's some place there which is connected with Lord Shiva.
那至于就是主 Shiva 在这个物质世界的地方，就据说在中国有一处圣地，就是你得去拉萨，然后呢再旅行几天就到达一个地方。
So, yeah, Lord Shiva has places, he has these residences. But Kailash is his main place, and Kailash is somewhere, it's a separate place, separate from this planet.
So, it's just these places, but the most important is Kailash. Kailash is a separate place.
Between material and spiritual world.
Kailash is 灵性世界和物质世界之间。
Okay.
Good day. 我们又还有人又提上来新的问题。刚才您讲到了要抓住灵性导师的兜底，他问是什么意思？怎么抓？怎么抓住圣帕帕德的粮
？Yeah.How do we catch hold of Prabhupada's dhoti?
Now you mentioned that. Yes.
So that means you have to very carefully and obediently follow all Prabhupada's instructions and do everything Prabhupada says. Be an obedient follower.
那意味着你要小心谨慎的，非常顺从的遵守 Prabhupada 的所有的训示，成为 Prabhupada 的追随者。
You do what Prabhupada, please Prabhupada, and then Prabhupada will take you back to Godhead.
Then Prabhupada, and Prabhupada will take you back to
Godhead. Okay, very good. Thank you very much. We'll stop here today. Okay, ma?
Good day. Gurde, 我们还有最后一个问题 ，Iswari Madaji 的，
yeah.
就是刚才您就是讲到个体灵，他说个体灵魂没有爱，只对 Krishna 有爱，那他们是以什么为前提相互之间形成夫妻关系的呢？物质世界是相互吸引才组成夫妻，那么灵性世界是靠什么组成这个家庭夫妻的？
You mentioned that between jivas there is no love, but in this material world, they are attracted with each other. They have some relationship. So in the spiritual world, what's the condition for them to become a husband and a wife?
Well, the you remember that they're spirit souls, so they're also part and parcel of Krishna. So you see them also as a part of Krishna.
灵魂都是 Krishna 的所属部分，所以必须把灵魂当作是 Krishna 的所属部分。
And husband and wife together, they can serve Krishna.
夫妻他们可以服务 Krishna.
They can help each other in the service to Krishna.
他们可以帮助彼此来服务 Krishna.
They don't just think that, oh, this person will satisfy my senses, but the devotee thinks they will help me in my service to Krishna.
他们不想，哦，这个人可以满足我的感官，他们想的是这个奉献者可以帮助我来服务
Krishna.
So much is a.
Yeah, go ahead, Guru Mahārāj.
It's a little broken. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So we have to see the spiritual world. We have spiritual bodies. We don't have spirit material senses which want sense gratification. We have spiritual bodies, spiritual senses, and we want to please Krishna. And sometimes being with a wife or can help us to serve Krishna.
We are 有灵体灵性有灵性的感官。我们没有物质的感官。那样，在灵性世界呢，我们这个灵体它可以帮助我们，就帮助彼此来服务 Krishna， 可以来取悦 Krishna。
But people in the bodily concept of life find it difficult to understand.
有躯体化概念的人很难理解。
But this is a fact. This is a fact. This is true.Guru Mani.Okay, I'm just saying this is the truth, this is fact, that the spiritual world is very different from your world, our world. Okay. Vami Yinga Jeshu, Taiwan.
Yes,
Gurde, we've finished. The last question is over. Okay. Shishin, Shishi Guru Mani, Shishi Sati.
Shishi Maharaj, Shishi Sati.
Hare Krishna.